Today we're going to talk about creating your own user stitch library in Stitchmastery version 3. You may be new to Stitchmastery, or you may have always used Stitchmastery with the default stitch libraries that are preloaded. Those do come with a lot of different stitches, but if you ever wanted to customise the appearance of your stitch, you may be aware that the default libraries can't be customised. For instance, if I wanted to change the appearance of my yarn over stitch, I will need to have my own user stitch library to allow me to do that. So the first thing we need to do is to open preferences. To find this, if you're using a Windows machine, as I am, preferences appears under tools. If you're using a Mac, you'll find a Stitchmastery menu here and preferences appears under that menu. So we open preferences and you may find that the drop-down menu here is closed, but click the arrow and then choose stitch libraries. So you'll see that there are 6 stitch libraries already in the program, and these are the default stitch libraries. We have 2 in Danish, 2 in German, and 2 in English. And to create your own version of one of these libraries, choose a library, click extend, and you'll see the Create New User Stitch Library dialog opens. So here we can change the name to suit. So I'll call this Hannah's Stitch Library. I could change the description if it would be useful. You can choose the folder you want to save your library in, and you can also change the file name itself. So hit apply and close. And you see that Stitchmastery opens the Stitch Library for you. So we can see here that this is Hannah's Stitch Library. And to demonstrate the difference, I will just very quickly customise the yarn over stitch so that I can show you the change in action. And we do have a separate video that explains much more clearly how to do this, but we're just going to show you very quickly. Okay, so I've just changed the appearance of my yarn over stitch and we're going to click OK. So we come back to the Preferences Stitch Libraries tab, and you can see that under the User Libraries version 3 tab, here is Hannah's Stitch Library. So we'll hit apply and close. And as you can see, nothing has changed. You need to tell Stitchmastery when you want to use your new library, because at the moment the default is to use one of the default libraries. So I have just clicked on Diagram and Edit Diagram Properties to open this dialog box, and I have selected the Stitch Library and Text Templates tab. Under Stitch Library, I'll click the drop down menu and we can see Hannah's Stitch Library is here. Hit refresh key and click OK, and we can see that the yarn over is now using the new symbol and the program is using my user stitch library.